Kenya seeks relief in new Eurobond as debt trap crisis deepens. Kenya's ICT bodies to deploy fiber optic cable in remote counties. Tanzania Osteria Farms signed $667 million to mine rare earths in a deal. And Safaricom retains position as most valuable brand in Kenya and East Africa. Plus, IMF to consider debt restructuring for countries facing insolvency. All right, so I'll start from the last story of the IMF considering debt restructuring for countries facing insolvency. Look, when you speak to people in government, they will tell you whatever money we are borrowing, we are putting it into proper use. The other technocrats, however, or analysts will tell you we need to regulate how much we borrow so we can focus on what we have and start paying back the debts. The most interesting thing is that there is always money available for anyone to borrow whenever they want. And for developing countries like Uganda, well, if your appetite to borrow is too high, you're going to head to that position where you do not know how much more you can borrow, but you still need the money. The question is the money borrowed being used to meet the actual goals that they are set to when we are going out to borrow? Or are we the kind that borrows money and then we start thinking, wait a minute, which department wanted money again? Or now let's do a feasibility study, or let's see which areas we need to invest in as the IMF looks to restructure debts for African countries. It's interesting because I tell you what, time and again, we need money to finance our budgets. And 2023-24 is coming through, so we need more money, definitely. We know how hard things have been for businesses. So domestically, we might not be able to raise as much as is expected of us. Welcome to the Business Show. My name is Simon. From wherever you're watching, we are glad you could make time. Here is what you can expect on this week's edition.
The world is changing, and we can no longer depend on analog or the way of doing things. So we must be able to adapt to the changing environment, which is so much hinged on technology.
Once again, welcome to the show. And this week we'll start with views from the top. And the whole conversation about how to empower women in business is one that forever stands on. Almost every person that runs a business and is a woman, if you talk to them, the first thing is financing. The other thing is the regulations are too tight on us. We need them to be loosened a bit. And government is saying, look, if you can formalize, good for you. However, the challenge is for most of these businesses, they are always in the small and medium enterprise categories, which makes it a bit harder for them to follow all the different guidelines to formalize. This week on Views from the Top, I speak to Spera Atuhaire, who is the chairperson of AMDA, an association of women from Bara Archdiocese, who are seeking to have their first annual expo here in Kampala. Now, the goal is simple. They're trying to rally women to get together, have a uniform voice and push for what they think is important for their businesses. Plus, also showcase the different products that women make. This and more in Views from the Top this week. All right, Madam Spera, thank you so much for making time and speaking to the Business Show. Welcome to the program.
Thank you. Hello, viewers. I am Spera Atuhaire, the chairperson of AMDA Women Council. I am here to talk about the forthcoming AMDA Women in Business Expo. The expo is going to take place on the 1st and 2nd of May, 2023. It is intended to provide women and members of AMDA and the general public an opportunity to showcase their businesses, an opportunity to gain knowledge and experience, to network with other business people, and also to have access to information that will help them grow and expand their businesses. So,
all right, welcome to the show once again. You talk about AMDA as it's an association of women, but maybe talk to us about where the whole idea of this AMDA association started and what is the goal behind it.
Okay.
And how the association comes into being.
Okay. AMDA is an association of Catholics who are hailing from Mbarara Archdiocese. So AMDA in whole is Archdiocese of Mbarara Development Association. It started way back so many years ago, like over 20 years ago. And the purpose of AMDA is built along seven pillars. The first one is unity, which aims at bringing people together so that they can network, so that they can grow and develop each other. And then we have a pillar on spiritual development. This is a faith-based association. The idea is that we are able to grow together in faith. We have an objective or a pillar on economic empowerment, where actually the business expo originates or is based. The idea of economic empowerment is to develop people economically, members of the association, to provide opportunities for their growth so that they are able to generate more income through a number of projects that we undertake, either developing skills or providing networking opportunities. We have a circle where members can save and borrow and invest in their businesses, so there are lots of opportunities. We have environmental sustainability because as an association and as Ugandans and as a church, we cannot not afford to pay attention to challenges affecting our environment. So the idea is to be able to contribute to the future sustainability of the country by doing initiatives that will sustain our environment. So based on that, we already have relationships with the National Forestry Authority on tree planting, but we are also developing other programs to sustain the environment. We have a pillar on health, which aims at ensuring that we are giving back to community to improve on their health situation. We organize medical camps on an annual basis. We provide health information to our members. We have a pillar on education that supports improvement of the education standards. We mobilize scholastic materials which meet and improve on management of schools by meeting teachers and all management structures and career guidance for students.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, let's get back to the whole conversation about the expo and business, to be precise. Why is the expo coming up around this time?
We all know that for us to grow as a community, we have to improve economically. So under the economic pillar of AMDA, one of the ways through which we want to develop our members is to provide members with access to information, to provide members with knowledge and skills, and with the relevant networks. We know that our members have been struggling, recovering from COVID-19, struggling to make ends meet, but also to get back on their feet, having had 2 years of businesses closed. But we also know, and why as women we are targeting, is that once we empower the women, then we are able to empower families, we are able to empower our society, and we know that women are the backbone of their homes. And we know that many women are involved in small businesses and would like to provide them with opportunity to be able to grow them so that they are able to compete well in the market. So the business expo is going to provide that opportunity because we'll be networking with a number of networks and organizations that are already supporting groups which are organized, and they would want to access skills, they would want to access financial support. And this can only happen if people are together. We also want to provide information on how they can formalize their businesses, how they can be able to understand the government regulations so that they are in position to comply, but also access the benefits that come with formalization.
Okay. I know for a fact that you're in a space of a bit of a finance-related conversations. First of all, why do you think most women-led businesses struggle to access financing and also generally formalization? Yes.
One of the challenges, like I mentioned, women are involved in small businesses. Now, there are a lot of requirements that individuals of small business enterprises have to fulfill to be able to formalize their businesses. So for our members to be able to benefit, it's important that they actually come together and work in groups, but also in the groups they will be able to access training facilities or opportunities. For instance, we are in discussion with the Women Entrepreneurs Association, WIL, which is already bringing women together, and they have access to information, they have access to markets, and they will be able to explain in detail what it takes to actually formalize the businesses. The other one, why people may be, especially women, failing to formalize their businesses, sometimes is lack of information on what it means, or fearing that if they formalize, the little money that they are earning will be taxed. So in this expo, we are hoping to partner with the regulatory agencies like URA, like the Registration Services Bureau, to break down all this information to our members so that they are able to understand and they can make informed decisions on registration, but also compliance with government regulations.
Thank you. Yeah. So for women watching this program, they're probably asking, what does one do to participate? Or is it entirely for women in Kampala or anyone that thinks they are women in business, they can take part?
We are generally targeting our members in the AMDA fraternity to come and showcase. However, the expo is open to other women and members of the public in Kampala and outside Kampala who are interested in showcasing what they are doing.
Okay. One of the things I noticed is, I think the theme is around leveraging technology and innovation. Maybe how important is technology and innovation in such times post-COVID for businesses?
Okay. Thank you very much. We all know that the world is changing. The world is changing. And we can no longer depend on analog or the way of doing things. So we must be able to adapt to the changing environment, which is so much hinged on technology to access information, technology to be able to market products, to be able to access financial solutions, or even to build systems that can help people run their businesses more efficiently. So technology is a very key factor. And then this year particularly, the theme for the International Women's Day was technology. So the question to us as women is how we are actually using technology, be it social media, be it the hard aspects of technology in building our business, or we are just there sharing just maybe news. But it is important that we all have the right skills and knowledge and what technology has to offer to improve the business. The other aspect of the expo is around environmental sustainability. We all know that many people have been affected by effects of climate change, but we would like to know how people have adapted within the climate change space to be able to expand their businesses. We are partnering with the organizations who are in the environment and energy sector, and they'll be showcasing how they have been able to innovate businesses within tapping into the environment so that we can coexist. We are building the sustainable futures, but members are able to benefit economically.
Okay, as we come to the end of this conversation, there's that bit about access to money for women. There's money, but that government has put, do you think enough has been done to support women in that space to access this money?
I think there's a lot of opportunities and programs that have been put in place by government. And these opportunities, I think one of the challenges is how information gets to the ordinary person, the channels through which this information is provided, but also for people to benefit, they have to be organized.
You know what? Amazing conversation there from Spera. And I like the fact that she says after COVID, we need to move away from the ordinary ways of doing things and look on how to leverage technology or leverage on technology to improve how we do business. For you that is watching, this expo will be happening down there at the Railway Grounds. And look, it's entirely free. And I keep saying, if you want to learn something about business, you need to step out and have your voice heard. Ask what you do not know, learn from those that know, and then see how to go. Just because you have saved money does not mean that you can start a business. There are basics you need to get right before you can start. So for those of you that have questions, why don't you make your way down there and find out just what the regulators are saying, those of you that are talking about URSB and how tough the policies are. You could find a better way of answering all those questions by attending the expo. So make it a date come May and learn something about your business. My name is Simon. You're watching The Business Show here on Urban TV. Time now to take a quick break on the program. When I get back, I'll be telling you more in the world of business. So in the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us on our socials. Drop all those comments and what you think about the program and generally how your business is faring. I'll see you shortly.